Este é o nome deles.
Yeah.
Fala, galera!
Bem-vindos!
Here you are. This is the first time that we're gonna be doing this, so I hope you guys come enjoy, talk with this guy here.
Hey guys, how you going? Rob? I'm Franco, who is here today, yeah.
As I said for you, yeah, we're gonna start to change everything.
Oh, wow! So I am on the camera now?
Yeah, we're on the camera. You can talk something.
Hey guys, welcome to our first episode. Rod, what we had to do today? Present ourselves, right?
Yeah, so today basically we're going to be presenting ourselves. We're going to be talking just a little bit what we do, what we can provide to our clients. And hopefully we can have fun and showcase our adventures, our problems. And all the things, all the amazing places that we've been, all the challenges, everything, and show maybe everything that happens on the background and what's happened every time that you film. And I think there are so many things, so many surprises that we are about to show, but keep tuning. We are gonna be really close and we're gonna show something to you. Maybe you are gonna learn something.
Yeah, we are working so hard in Skyper since a few months ago already that we did our rebrand. Rod, how long already that you are working in Skyper, you, when you create Skyper a few years ago?
Skyper, originally we started this business in 2016.
Yeah.
And since then, we've been working and create like aerial content for so many different businesses, so many different companies. And yeah, we are proud to all the projects, everything that we've done so far.
Yeah, we did a rebrand last year in 2022.
Yeah, that's a good point. Talk about this rebrand. Who did that?
Okay, I did that. We did together. We did together because the brand is not just a logo, but
he's a humble guy.
Yeah. Okay, we can talk about our professions, right? You're a drone pilot, the real holder, which is the most important thing, right, in a drone company. What is REOC for the people that don't know? REPL, what is some difference between each other? Because some people is interested in that as well.
Cool. What's happened is when we start to fly a drone and start to do this professionally, things start to be a little bit more not so fun as when you are flying by yourself. So there are a few procedures, few things that you have to do, some documentations, especially to be in compliance with CASA, which is the organization that regulates everything, especially when you talk about aviation.
Yeah, yeah.
I forgot that word. But when you talk about aviation, CASA is the one, is the organization responsible. And for you to work as a company, you have to have like a certificate for your company, which mm-hmm. is called AROC.
Yeah.
Which is Remote Operation and Certificate.
Yeah.
Operator Certificate.
Yeah.
We can put that and
we can
fix this because you are live. That's the problem. Yeah. We're not going to be cutting anything. We're going to try to make this as real as possible.
That means that you can be like drone pilot, but at the same time, you need a more paperwork to fly commercially. So just with my drone pilot license, I cannot fly commercially, right? Here in Australia.
Yeah, the difference is, For example, let's say that you need to fly on the within 5K from Perth Airport.
Yeah.
There are some places that you need to do this as well. And you need to request like permits with CASA. And to do that, you as a pilot, even though that you can have like the REPL, which is the remote pilot license, it doesn't mean that you are allowed to talk with CASA directly. So a company that holds the REOC, they are the ones that are the one that can apply, have contact someone. Generally, this company needs to have like a chief remote pilot, and this is the person that is allowed to talk with CASA, send all the documentation, requests, everything, and he will be the focal point between CASA and your company to get the permits to make things happen.
I think that is the huge step up, because so many, you know, when you are working maybe in a business or in a company, and maybe the marketing team is looking for aerial shot or some marketing content, the first thing maybe that a person from that company says is, I have my cousin that has a drone and I can do some content for the company, right? Which is fair. Maybe it's a good drone, but it's not just to go and buy a drone to fly commercially and do some marketing professional assets, but it's if more about, you know, this kind of special permission that you got to fly commercially in Australia, specifically talking. It's other thing about liabilities as well, which is really important if something wrong happened. So it's, you know, it's not just simple toys like many people maybe looks the or see the drones, right? So it's important.
Yeah, that's why I said for you, the fun part to fly drones start to be not that fun anymore.
Yeah.
All because all the paperwork, everything they have to do. So, which is good because it separates you from other people that think that can do everything, and big companies, they know about all the certifications, everything that you need. So that gives you an advantage, especially when you work with big companies. Otherwise, nowadays it's so easy. You can go in any place here, we can buy a drone and you can start to fly. And even the mini drones and everything, the quality start to be amazing.
Yeah.
So it's not hard for you to operate a drone. However, there are many things that implicate the liability, as you said, that you need to be aware of. Being like the first episode or first,
yeah,
let's call episode or what we should call.
I think we have like a issue there, because we don't know if it's like an episode for YouTube or it's a podcast for maybe Spotify. But we can be everywhere, right?
We could call Epicast. Anyway,
that's good.
Because this is the first one, right?
Yeah.
And not everyone know us. So, have said that. Talk about who is Franco and what do you do at Skyper, Franco?
Okay, Franco is an Argentinian guy that I came to Australia in 2019. And yeah, we started working together with Rod in Skyper since 2021, a couple of years already. So yeah, at the beginning I started like as a graphic designer because it's my main profession. And then I became like drone pilot with the time. I did my REPL. But at that time I was flying also FPV drones, which they are like some custom drones that I build at home and they fly really amazingly. So yeah, we are offering some services together with Rod since 2021. Ground videography, photography, aerial assets, FPV stuff as well, is other kind of regulation that now we need to follow, and we are doing some paperwork to fly legally here in Australia because it's pretty hard, right, to get those permissions. Also because it's maybe the cinema industry is asking for those kind of shots. Of course, if those shots are in the cinema industry, then the business and the companies wants to do something similar that they see in the movies, they watch in the series. So yeah, we are making something really cool about drones. We are improving our skills with the FPV. We are still offering amazing drone content with the amazing drones that Rod has. So yeah, we are working together really, really hard. I am so happy to be here.
And what do you like most to do here at Skyper?
Each day is different, you know.
Why?
Because you have so many professions in one place. It's like it's a multitasking job, and you need to, you know, fly drones, edit photos, edit videos, I don't know, be photographer, I don't know, everything, but which is really cool, right? We are like a real content creator, so it's no other way, it's no other word to, you know, to describe.
But the good thing about that is every day is a different day.
Yes.
We never know what's going to happen next week, so we are in different place, we are doing different stuff, and I think that's the beauty about what we do. Otherwise, you're going to be doing the same thing all the time.
We did that before. We were working in offices, like in regular jobs, you know, and we know about that part. I think both of us, we are so happy. Today, for example, in this first episode, we were learning a lot how to use those machines that we are, because we have to say that we are, you and me, like managing everything right now, you know? We are putting the effects, the music, you know?
Yeah, pretty much. I don't know, I can show it to everyone, but I have one, my hand here is pretty much like cutting and changing.
Doing magic.
It's pretty much like fairy tale. I'm pretty much, we can need to change everything here in my hand, my left hand, so I need to hide my hand, and Franco is here, change everything. I have the computer. So we learn every day.
Yeah.
So, and I think that will be something that potentially we could be doing in near future as well, and showing all the things that we are learning, all the things that we are having, like challenging and maybe struggling a little bit. But of course, many people can have the same issues or try to learn the same things or want to do something differently. So we can maybe cut their time and help them to do something different.
It's so many stuff that we can, we want to show them, and so many, I don't know, little tasks or maybe equipment that we are really excited to show you guys. So I don't know, since specific drones, we have the Inspire, Mavic 3, the new FPV Avata from DJI, also GoPros, because sometimes we need to shoot with GoPros and matching with the bigger cinema cameras, the color grading. So it's so many stuff that we are working around every day that is really, you reach that point that, you know, and you're with so many people around that knows a lot about, I don't know, color grading, editing, that we're going to talk about in this podcast soon. And at a certain point, you want to, you know, give that information to everyone else to you know, to step up maybe some of the skills, because you sometimes want to teach someone else how to do those stuff, and you have to every day, because you need to teach someone else how to do, like for example me, how to do like any kind of job, so you can be free to do other stuff, and it's something that we are learning together every time.
Yeah, I think every day is a day to learn something completely different, and that's the beauty about what we do, and we love what we do. And we hope with all this challenging and the things that we are doing completely different, we can start to create like content that can entertain people, that can help everyone. We are not here only to work, but also we would love to help people, to serve them, and use ourselves as well with everything that we are doing to maybe help someone to create their own content. They can be their own creative agency and do something amazing by themselves. So I think that's the goal, especially because only people think that we fly drones, right? But there are so many other things that we've been doing so far. So we work with content strategy, marketing strategy, brand development. We have our brand strategy here.
Yeah,
but there are so many things that we do, and people don't realize. They always relate us with drone.
Yeah.
And maybe you can try to demystify that and show, hey guys, we can do a little bit more than that, and maybe help a lot of people, and that's our goal.
Yeah, exactly. I remember I was watching some footage that you did in 2016, a few days ago, and it's amazing how the technology, and also, I don't know, the color grading, the assets that you were showcasing before, have changed with the time, you know, and I am I am impressive how also I saw your vision at that time, 2016. I see those shots. I see that quality as well. I know it maybe it's not the best one, but I can see that, you know, you had the eyes at that moment, and I know that you were working really hard since then. But yeah, I want to ask you, because I want everyone knows, which are the clients that you had the opportunity to work with in the last few years?
Client is
it's like a it's good to just say that, because the client is not the word that you use for to define them, right?
Yeah, generally I don't say clients. I'll always like to say partners, because we always try to create like a lasting relationship, and it's not only sales, it's not only provide something, finish, give me the money, right? So we always try to talk with them what they need. It's everything the way that you need it. Do you need something more? Do we need to change the deliverables, everything? And we are sometimes we are in a point that if our client is not happy, we give the money back and we pretty much like do something to you, the client is happy. That never happened, but it could happen some days, and we always try to pretty much like try to work around and make things being looking good. So quality and service, customer service, is something that always we are proud of, to provide something really good to our clients. And when you talk about clients here, especially here in WA,
yeah,
I believe you've been working with some big names and some big clients that make us proud, especially when you see the result. We walk on the street, we see on billboards and ads on TV. Mm-hmm. Even when you go to watch like Netflix, Apple TV.
Yeah. Skypert is there.
Disney Plus. So yeah. There are a few things that we are proud, and we've been lucky to work with some really, really, really good clients.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Also the opportunity to work with other big, maybe, creators, right? What other content producers, other companies, when we are learning a lot every day, and we are so proud of that as well, because this is kind of sometimes a big community of content producers that sometimes you have to support one each other, and maybe sometimes you don't have the capabilities to do something, you need someone else, and someone else when you need some aerial shot of certain things, or when they need some assets, they can ask other companies. So that is good when you have that synergy with other content creators company. So it's pretty cool. I saw that as well.
And Franco, tell me, working at Skyworth, what is the project that you love most, that you say, oh man, I'm so proud and I love to do this?
Yeah, you know that is one that which changed almost my life, which was the Optus Stadium project, when we flew the FPV for the great final in 2021. Because not because the project, maybe the final project, but how everything was happening, right? As I said a few minutes ago, I start as graphic designer in the company in April. I wasn't like a professional drone pilot at that time, but I was improving my FPV skills, and this job happened on September, like a few months after I started in the company as a graphic designer. And you told me, are you sure that you can do this? Because I have this client that is asking for this kind of shot. And I say, yeah, we can try. You can or you cannot. Yeah, can. Okay, let's do that. So we did that one shot in the Optus Stadium. We were the first one that we flew FPV inside of the stadium in that way, you know, in a really long shot, showing the play, showcasing all the stadium, flying through the seats, through really tight holes over there as well. It was really good. And then finishing the shot, showing the cap in the middle of the field was really, really good. So yeah, we were around Australia because it was so popular that video around the TV, in YouTube, like kind of 40,000 views, which is pretty cool for to be Australia, you know. Yeah, so that job, that project was really good. Also because we started like creating this process how to make the FPV happen, which is, you know, the first step, go one day, check the place, take all those safety, you know, procedures, walk around, draw a map, the flight path, and then go the next day and shoot a few times and choose the final clip that they want to. And yeah, we start creating this kind of process, and nowadays we are, you know, having so many inquiries about FPV, and that is pretty cool for us.
That's good, Frank. And I remember that the process, everything was not so simple. I remember that we had to do one day before, try and test for, I don't know, four or five hours.
Yeah, 4 or 5 hours.
And batteries, drone signage, that.
We can talk about FPV maybe in any specific
context. Of course. Trying to remember, because you said that, and that was a really incredible project, and you did a really amazing job there.
Yeah.
We are really proud about what you did.
Thank you so much.
And I'm glad that you did.
Yeah, it was really cool. Really cool.
And being the first episode, or whatever we're going to be calling this, right? What do you think we could be telling or could be talking about it? That ask me something. What do you think it could be?
Yeah. Okay. But we were talking about this project, this episode for a while now, and now we are making this happen. And I really want to know what do you have in mind? Why is the main goal of this kind of project in SkyPerth? Because also it's a pretty new, you know, niche for us to discover and go together. Because to be honest, we never did something like this. We are with cameras, with microphones every day, with drones, but it's our first time that we sit here and we talk in front of the camera. We are every time behind. What is your main goal for this podcast or episodes?
I think the main goal potentially will be entertain people.
Yeah.
Because to be honest with you, we are not... English is not our main language, right? So I don't think
they realize that.
So I believe at least people are going to be having laughing about what we see or say, especially because of our accent or everything.
Yeah.
However, that needs to be clear that despite the fact that we have all these language challenge, right? We are really professional, and we are capable to do stuff that not everyone that are willing to do. And the main thing for me is I realize for all these 6 to 7 years that I'm doing drone stuff, sometimes it's really hard to find details, like how to do one thing, how to do that thing. And I don't know if people are too concerned about it, to share knowledge, to share things. So my idea will be not only to show the good part of what we do, but also help people and create content that they can pretty much like use for do something amazing, maybe create their own business, do something that can help them, like to provide to our families, provide to their kids or whatever they want to do, but something that they can be meaningful. And I hope we can achieve that.
Yeah. Also, we are working in some guides and presentations, so you guys have the possibility to download for free, of course. And yeah, we are thinking about that as well, how we can improve the skill of the people that they are watching this video, maybe you are starting out with this business or you want to learn more about drones. Also, we are planning to talk about more about why you need to choose a drone company, a licensed drone company, or how to choose this kind of aerial companies in our case, because as we say, we have all the paperwork, this license, the insurance. And yeah, we want to teach all those stuff along those, these kind of episodes, this kind of guides that we are planning to give you guys. So yeah.
And I like the way that you're saying, because there's one thing probably, I believe people are gonna be interested about it.
Yeah.
Which is really challenging for us to fly FPV here in Australia, right?
Oh yeah.
So I believe we have really some good news for everyone, and that will be a game change for us as well, and that you'll be like a pretty much like a good episode.
That's right, episode. Yeah,
that'll be a good episode that we're gonna be talking with you and saying to you a few challenges that we've been we are having to get the permits to fly the drones legally.
How to choose my first drone as well, because many people can is starting out with FPV drones already because they can buy a FPV drone in the JB Hi-Fi, I don't know.
Oh, DJI, you can buy like an Avatar fly.
That's why. And that is the question, is it legal or is not? So we need to talk about this in another episode.
Perfect, let's hold that.
Yeah, let's hold
that. We can come back and we're gonna be talking about FPV. But guys, just to wrap this up, I think that's basically what we want to talk with you. We are gonna be creating this channel to entertain you with Spanish.
Yeah, por supuesto, vamos a divertirnos.
And Portuguese. Acredito que eu vou tentar fazer alguma coisa para vocês também.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you so much for being with us. I hope you get at least laugh a little bit. Yeah. And soon we're gonna create something amazing for you guys. And as Franco said, for this first episode, and we always gonna try to create something that we can give to you as well. So we are cooking like a kind of a guide for beginners, so that we can share with them for free. So stay tuned. The link for this manual will be here already.
Yeah, we're gonna be in the description of the video.
Cool.
So you can download.
Fantastic.
For free.
And guys, and if you have any questions, anything that you need to ask us, any suggestions about what you could be talking about,
right?
We can talk about soccer.
Yeah, we can talk about football, football, no soccer.
We can talk about drones. We can talk about.
And of course, one idea we didn't mention is we are planning to have some interviews as well here in the.
Oh, interviews!
Yeah,
that would be amazing.
That would be amazing.
We are gonna be interviewing like cookers, chefs, anyone that is interested to contribute with this channel. Put like the joke apart, of course. The funny part is the main thing, as I said, it's basically for us to entertain people and to give information that people can learn something every day. So I hope every time that you launch something, every time that you create something here, you guys are learning something. So that will be a main thing. We're gonna bring people that can help you to further your career, further your studies, and can be something really soon.
Okay, thank you so much, Rod.
Thank you. See you soon, guys.
Bye. Woo!
Change his music. You have to put like a samba or something. Or
sorry.
Whatever will be the music.
This is the behind the scenes.
Oh, really? And why do you have a warning here?
Because.
What's this warning talk about?
No, I don't know. I have to check it out.
Oh, nice. And it doesn't. I know that's here because you cannot remove.
Yeah,
Oh, that's perfect. There we go.
That's good.
Can you see it here? Wardy! I don't know if you're gonna be see. He's not gonna change. No. Don't try to be a hero.
Don't try to be a hero. Try to be a hero.
See you guys. Bye! Woo!